So, we're out here again. The mosquitoes aren't near as bad. We've had a frost. And, it's a little more comfortable to be out here in the stand. You can probably hear the tractors in the background harvesting beans. We just had the blood moon and then full moon. It's been bright, so we'll see if that has any effect on the deer movement today. Hopefully we get a shot at something and put some meat in the freezer. One thing about the woods right now, you can see it still looks pretty green, but I'd say probably 50% or more, or 50% or more of the leaves have fallen, and walking through the woods is very noisy, so anything coming up on us, we should be able to hear. Keep your fingers crossed for me. And like to send one of these Rage hypodermics at some backstrap, so my trigger finger is getting itchy. This time of year, it's the second week of October. Has been good to me in the past when it comes to grunting. I think the deer are, the bucks are separating themselves from their bachelor groups and looking for groups of does, because we'll be ready to start chasing them during the rut here in about a month, probably less. So here, it worked for me well in the past, this time of year. Actually, probably the best time of year for grunting for me is during this October lull, as they call it. It's worked good for me here and when I hunt at home, well, where my mom lives in Arkansas. So it's always worth a shot, just don't overdo it. The other thing is
you can see where he ducks the arrow as it's on its way, and I end up hitting him right above the front shoulder. And on this next, at the end here, I'll be able to slow it down even more, and then on this opposite side you can see the arrow that's coming through on his right side as it's exiting.
An 8-point, not the biggest buck in the land, but a good 8-point. Looks like the little rage ripped him up. Almost about a 50-yard shot over there to the edge of that trail. He's laying right back there. He only ran 50, 60 yards. Laying right back there, yes. Heck yes. Alright, I just shot a buck out here. It was about a little over 50 yard shot, which I practice at all the time, but in these woods, sometimes you don't think you're gonna get a shot like that, but it's good to practice it. He came out of absolutely nowhere where I was never expecting. I've hunted this place a few times. Few years, and he just came from the middle of a field, so I mean, you just never know. So I shot him, he crashed less than 50 yards, shot him with the old Rage hypodermic, first year I've used those, and he sure didn't go far. So let's go take a look at it here before it gets too dark. First blood right there, exactly where he is standing. Look at the blood. Look at that. I have to come back in the morning to film this blood trail from this rage. My goodness. Hype around these broadheads. But finally tried them. You know what's funny is I know where the deer's laying. But isn't it just fun sometimes to follow the blood trail? I don't know why. But hey, let's go get him. There he is, laid up on here in this branch. Can't tell me that rage didn't puncture that thing. My goodness, look at that. That's insane. Insane. Not my biggest buck, but yeah. There's nothing like a bow kill. Nothing like bow hunting. Right on. Good little buck here. Nice one. Hunting out here on some property that I've had access to, and you know, I've seen a couple bucks in my few years hunting out here that are bigger than this, but you know, there's not that many. Just a few sparse little wood lots and stuff like that, and a nice buck. Now, time to fill my surplus doe tags.